Hello friends, so let's continue with the reactive intermediate, and this is the part 4. So we have given a keto, and now what happens, will form a enamine, right? So it will form an enamine, which is amine. We have this amine group, so it will form an enamine, right? So what will be the structure of the enamine? Will be like, okay, so the formation of this enamine is preferred at the less hindered site. So this is the more hindered site, this is the less hindered site. Here methyl is there, here no methyl is there. So this will form enamine over here. This is the enamine, in an amine. So we have given alpha beta unsaturated keto. What will happen then? Lone pair pushes, it will undergo 1,4 addition. Okay, fine. So we are basically getting this one iminium ion, and here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon we have here, O minus, and a double bond here, right? Okay, so this will undergo tautomerization, and it will take up a proton. So it will take up a proton, right? So what is forming, right? So it's basically forming a keto. Fine. Now we have given acid in presence of water. So hydrolyze this. If we hydrolyze this here, it will form a keto. Fine. Okay. Now we have given aqueous base and heat. So in presence of aqueous base, it will undergo aldol condensation. It will undergo aldol condensation reaction. So from where it will abstract the proton? It will abstract the proton from here. Okay. And this one will attack this carbonyl carbon, right? So formation of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 member ring. So we have a 5 member ring, and here we have a 6 member ring. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. In the 4th position, this 3rd position, we have a keto. 4 positions attacking, and here we have the O minus, right? O minus. So this O minus will become a OH group in presence of acid. Now we have given heat. So as we have given heat, so there is elimination of water molecule, right? So after the elimination of water molecule, what we are going to get, this alpha beta unsaturated keto, this fused system, right? So just roughing this one. So we got this one. I'm writing over here again. 6 member, so 5 member ring, right? Fine. Now you have given a sulfur elide. So there are 2 types of sulfur elide. So one is the sulfur elide, and another one is this type. Fine. So this is sulfoxonium elide, this is sulfur elide, right? Now let's see, this negative charge is not stabilized, whereas this negative charge is stabilized by this oxygen group. Okay, so because of this destabilized negative charge. This negative charge, this sulfur electrolyte is hard. So this is hard, and since it is undergoing conjugation, so it becomes a soft. Okay, so if you have a system like this, if we have a system like this, so this carbon is hard and this carbons, these are soft. So in presence of sulfur electrolyte, which is hard, this sulfur electrolyte attacks in this hard center to form epoxide like this. Okay, but if we use this soft sulfoxonium electrolyte, then what happens? Then it will remain intact. This soft double bond will undergo, this will form a cyclopropane ring. So it is in presence of sulfoxonium electrolyte, this one, and this is in presence of sulfur electrolyte. But let's say if you have no option, then the option which only, if you have the only one option, then only one option that will fit, we'll discuss in the next example. Okay, so here we have a hard center, we have a soft center. So we have a sulfur electrolyte which is hard. So this sulfur electrolyte is hard. So it will basically add in this carbonyl carbon. So the product will be this one, right? So this is a product. Okay, so let's move to the second one. So I'm keeping this okay, so let's say we have, and this is the methyl groups, right? Okay, and we have two types of OH group. One is a primary OH group, one is a tertiary OH group. Now, as you know, tosyl chloride in presence of pyridine, so tosyl chloride always favored the less hindered OH, like it will prefer a 1 degree alcohol rather than a 2 degree. So if we give a H plus over here, like say HCl, then what happens? If we add HCl over here, then let's say this one is there, so the formation of carbocation will be here. Okay, but as we have used a tosyl chloride, so what will happen in presence of tosyl chloride pyridine? So it will basically form OTS in the primary alcohol, not in the tertiary or any other secondary alcohol. Here it will form a OTS, right? Now you have calcium carbonate, which is a base. Calcium carbonate, it will abstract this proton, right? So it will form a double bond over here, and this ring will expand and this OTS will leave. So it leads to formation of a 7-member ring, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have a keto over here, and this, right? This one, 7-member ring. Now you have given a sulfoxonium electrolyte. Base means what happens here? SO is there, right? So S plus. So base will abstract this proton. So this leads to a sulfoxonium electrolyte, and this is soft, right? Soft. But we don't have any option. We don't have any double bond. We have only this carbonyl. So since we don't have any option, so this soft will attack this hard center, because we don't have option. If there is a double bond, say is a double bond over here, then it will prefer this double bond over this keto. But since we don't have any option, we don't have any double bond, so it will add up there only, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Still add up here. So this will be the product. Fine. So in the next videos I will solve more examples so that I will get a clear idea about the mechanisms and all the ways how to solve this type of problems. So that's all for the video, and thank you for watching.